stopped off at the scales. So now I'm going to move on to the fins. Okay. So, all right. I'm going to start over here and I'm going to work my way towards the fish. Okay. So I'm starting with that yellow again. I'm going to go kind of dark with it on the very edge of the tail. And as it gets towards the center, I'm going a little bit lighter just so that I can blend that in. Again, dark towards the edge. And as I go towards the center, I'm going to get lighter. I'm not sure what happened here. It looks like it's got some marks on it. Don't know where it came from, but definitely want to get those up as much as I can. Okay, I'm gonna go with this yellow orange. What I'll have to do is I'll have to do another layer of the yellow over top of this just so that it gets that really nice blended yellowish orange look about it. Because right now it's kind of unsaturated and almost pastel looking, and I don't want that. Pastel is in the colors, not the medium. Okay, I'm gonna get back over top with my yellow. Sorry, dropped my crayon, or not my crayon, jeez, dropped my colored pencil. All right, so I'm gonna go darker in here and I'm gonna blend it out into that. So just like with the fish itself, with the scales, it's a process, basically going back and forth, adding your colors on top of each other, blending them together, so that you get this nice smooth transition. And that's really going to be what makes it look nice in the end. Time for my darker orange. All right, I'm liking the way that looks so far. Now it's time to go in with the red. It's gonna be really dark right up against here, and it's gonna get lighter as it goes out towards the end. Right now, it's not really blended, but I'm going to go back in with my orange and help it blend a little bit more. So, back in with the orange. Help it blend a little bit smoother. Yeah, that gives it still a little bit harsh from one to the next, so I'm going to just add a little bit more. I'm going to blend it a little bit better. So, sometimes you have to kind of take a step back to see if it's doing what you want it to. Sometimes the camera helps me with that, because up close to me it looked like it was pretty blended, and then when I looked at it through the camera lens it was a very harsh line between the red and the orange that I'm not digging too much. That's better. Much better. Okay, so same idea. Towards the outside edge is going to be my bright yellow. As it gets towards the fish, it's going to turn to that red. So, again, same thing. I'm going to go start with my bright yellow first. Okay, where it goes underneath here, I'm not going to do anything with that. I don't want it. That's all going to be the shades of blue there. So, okay. All Now I'm getting a little bit of that muddied look from this one special line that's really dark, but it's kind of too late now. If I was going to erase it, I would have had to erase it before I started adding my color. So I'm just going to have to realize that it's going to get some of that lead muddied look bleeding in, but not much I can do about it. Okay, let's put some yellow on top of that. Notice how, like, if it's more comfortable, I'll just turn the paper, because sometimes, you know, you'll notice that you tend to shade or color better if your hand's in a certain position. So rather than put it in an awkward position, just turn your paper. Orange in here. I like how that looks. All right, right here is not going to be much of a transition. There's not. So this is the top part. The fin's just bent. It's bent this way. So, there's not much room for, you know, transition from red to yellow in this part. So I'm just going to kind of go with that. All right, so same thing with these. It's going to be yellow towards the edge. It's going to get red towards the center. Okay? So I'm liking the way it's looking so far, though. It's kind of got a nice look about it. I'm just going to lighten this up a little because I don't want all that lead to bleed into my fins. okay. So my yellow orange right here. And see what it does when you go over top of it, the lead with your color pencil, see how it darkens it? I'm not sure why that happens, but it really does. Okay, a bit more of this on the very edge, and then we're going to go in with the darker. All right, and now for this fin right up here. So same idea, yellow towards the outside, red towards the inside. The red is going to kind of blend in with this side of your fish a little bit. That's okay. And the last part for this right here is going to be the red. That's it for the fins, guys. So that's basically it for the fish itself. Stay tuned for video number 3. That's going to deal with all of the background. So basically all of our water and the splashes over top of your fish and everything like that.